Hello, welcome to PG Pathshala. This is paper 6, Radiation Biophysics and module 8, Scattered Radiation in Medical Imaging. I am Dr. Sunil Dutt Sharma from Radiological Physics and Advisory Division of Bhabha Atomic Research Center, Mumbai. The objective of this module is to explain the following. Number one, the production of scattered photons in projection radiography. Generally in medicine, but here we will specifically talk in context of general radiography. What is projection radiography? Contrast, that is subject, image and displayed contrast. A scatter fraction SF and a scatter to primary ratio SPR. Magnitude of a scatter and its dependence on imaging variables such as X-ray energy, field size, patient thickness and angle of incidence. Effect of a scattered radiation on the quality of image or radiograph. Methods of minimizing the amount of a scattered radiation and features and roles of anti-scatter grids in projection radiography. We will also see in brief a few other methods of minimizing the scattered, because scattered is unwanted radiation in medical imaging. So, just to introduce the subject, for obtaining information about internal anatomy of a region of a patient, X-ray based imaging technique is used. The X-ray energy selected to produce the image must be sufficient to penetrate through the tissues and organs coming in the path of the beam. It is also important for obtaining an image of the region of interest that the X-ray photons should interact through the process of absorption, attenuation or scattering with the tissues and organs concerned, so that the photons detected by the image recorder would contain useful information regarding the internal anatomy. Projection radiography is one of the medical imaging techniques in which an image of a three-dimensional object, that is the patient, is recorded in two dimensions, resulting from superposition of the anatomy along each radiation ray. In this technique of medical imaging, X-rays of energy 20 to 120 keV are used. These X-rays interact with the body tissues by photoelectric effect as well as by Compton scattering. The probability of Compton scattering in body tissue is about the same as for the photoelectric effect at 26 keV, and above 26 keV, the Compton scattering is dominant. In case of higher atomic number material like bone, which has effective Z of 13, the probability of interaction of X-rays of energy about 35 keV through photoelectric effect and Compton scattering is approximately the same. The X-rays of energy over 35 kV are generally used for almost all the radiographic procedures except mammography, and hence enough scattered X-ray photons are produced in almost all the radiographic procedures except mammography. So, with this introduction, now we will discuss some salient features of projection radiography. Projection radiography is a planar imaging technique where image of a three-dimensional object is recorded in two dimensions, as we discussed earlier. So, the figure shows a setup used in projection radiography technique. The X-rays pass through the patient body, both primary and scattered, are recorded by the image recorder, that is a radiographic film. The diagnostic utility of a medical image so obtained depends on the quality of the image and the conditions of its acquisition. The quality of the image acquired is basically a compromise between the ideal requirements and practical feasibility. The scattered photons violate the basic geometric premise that photons travel in straight lines and hence they do not add any information to the image, rather contributes in minimizing the image quality. Some of the scattered photons leaves the body in the same general direction as the primary beam and exposes the image recorder and reduces image contrast. The meaning of contrast is difference in the gray scale of the image. So, this technique has been illustrated in the figure shown in this presentation. FID means focus to imager distance, OID means object to imager distance, and AEC means automatic exposure control. So, before going in detail by studying effect of a scattered radiation, we must know what is the meaning of contrast, SF and SPR. Contrast is defined as the ratio of the signal difference between the object and the background to the average signal. In medical imaging, it is desirable to achieve a high contrast to visualize disease features of the patient imaged. A uniform gray image has no contrast, whereas an image with dark gray and light gray has high contrast. There are three types of contrast, namely subject contrast, image contrast, and display contrast. Subject contrast is defined as the contrast of the object in the scene being imaged, and it depends on the X-ray spectrum and the attenuation of the object and background. Image contrast depends on the subject contrast and the characteristic of the image receptor, that is detector. The contrast of the image as displayed for final viewing by an observer is display contrast, which depends on the image contrast and the gray scale characteristic of the display device. For a monochromatic spectrum under ideal imaging condition, contrast C is equal to ratio of delta B upon B, where B is image brightness or shade of gray in a background region, and delta B is the difference in brightness of a small object. This can also be given by C is equal to delta I by I. Here I is X-ray intensity and delta I is difference in X-ray intensity. Now, contrast for polychromatic X-rays. For polychromatic X-rays and in the absence of a scatter, the contrast which is denoted here by Cp is equal to 1 minus exponential minus mu d minus mu b into xd. Here xd is object thickness, mu d is linear attenuation coefficient of the object, and mu b is linear attenuation coefficient of the background. So, a scatter may be quantified by a scatter fraction. A scatter fraction, which is generally written as SF, is equal to ES upon EP plus ES. Here, EP is energy of primary X-rays absorbed in a small region of image receptor, and ES is energy of a scattered X-rays absorbed in a small region of image receptor. To continue the contrast for polychromatic X-rays, a scatter may also be quantified by a scatter to primary ratio, SPR. SPR is given as ES upon EP. SPR depends on X-ray field size, patient thickness, and X-ray energy. SF, that is a scatter factor, and SPR are related as SF is equal to 1 plus 1 upon SPR to the whole inverse. In the presence of a scattered radiation, subject contrast CS is equal to 1 minus exponential minus mu d minus mu b into xd into 1 upon 1 plus SPR, which is equal to Cp into 1 upon 1 plus SPR. Here 1 plus SPR inverse is contrast reduction factor, that is CRF, or contrast degradation factor. Thus, an SPR of 1 reduces the contrast by a factor of 2, and an SPR of 2 reduces contrast by a factor of 3. The term SP 1 plus SPR inverse is called the contrast reduction factor or contrast degradation factor. The SPR depends on the area of the X-ray field, that is field of view, the thickness of the patient, and the energy of the X-rays. The contrast is generally expressed in terms of percentage, and hence the image contrast with a scatter, that is CS, is inversely related to the scatter factor SF, and can be given by CS percentage is equal to 100 by S or SF. Now we will see what is the magnitude of a scattered radiation in diagnostic radiology. The magnitude of a scattered photons depends on radiographic procedure, X-ray field size or beam aperture, patient thickness, KV setting, and the position in 3D. The magnitude of a scattered photons strongly depends on the radiographic procedure, depending on whether the area of interest is a region consisting largely of bone or soft tissue or combination of both. This is due to the fact that scattered interactions, coherent and incoherent, are predominant for soft tissue, and the photoelectric effect is predominant for bone. The magnitude of a scatter photon increases with increasing field size up to a saturation level, beyond which either little or no increase in a scatter fraction, that is ratio of a scattered photon energy to total photon energy, occurs. So the figure shows the variation of a scatter fraction with field size for 80 kV X-rays. With field size for phantom thickness 5, 10, 20, 30 cm, and this is for 80 kV setting of the tube voltage. The variation of a scatter fraction with phantom thickness for 4 different field sizes at 80 kV energy is also shown. So it is observed from this figure that a scatter fraction increases rapidly with patient thickness and tends to saturate for large thickness. Now table shows the scatter fraction and a scatter to primary ratio data at center and away from the center along the axis and diagonal of 30 cm by 30 cm X-ray field. The proportion of a scattered radiation is found to be highest in the center, less at the edges, and least at the corners of the field. So just to show the dependence of a scatter on position in region of interest, we have collected data from different locations of the region of interest. So now here in this table you can see distance from center is taken in first column, and a scatter factor and a scatter to primary ratio, that is SPR, on axis and diagonal axis are shown in other two columns. So now you can see when the distance from center is 0, the values of SF, SPR are almost highest, and when we go down, that is distance from center is 2.5 centimeter, the value of SF is slightly smaller than the earlier value, but the value of SPR is somewhat further less than the earlier value. And in this way, if we go to a larger distance on axis and on diagonal axis, we see that the value of SF varies slightly, but value of SPR is varies significantly. This is true for both on axis and in diagonal axis, but in case of diagonal axis the variation is little larger. So in general we say that the proportion of scatter radiation is highest in the center of region of interest, less at the edges of region of interest, and least at the corners of region of interest. The magnitude of scattered radiation depends on the KV setting as well. However, this is the case for inefficient image receptors only. So, the figure shows variation of scatter fraction on KV setting in case of irradiation of 20 cm thick phantom using 30 cm by 30 cm X-ray field for Kodak Linux regular and efficient ray earth system and power speed calcium tungsten and inefficient system detector systems. It is observed from this figure that the scatter fraction for the Kodak Linux regular is independent of KV setting, whereas the scatter fraction increases with energy for the power speed calcium tungsten screen. Now we will see the effect of scattered radiation on image quality. As discussed earlier, a scattered radiation comprises majority of the radiation detected by image receptor during examination of large body regions. In a skin film, in a screen film radiography, a scattered radiation causes a loss of contrast in the image, which is quantified by CRF or CDF or S. In case of abdominal radiography, at least a 20 cm thick patient is examined using an X-ray field of 35 cm by 35 cm, which corresponds to an SPR value of 3. This means for every primary photon incident on the screen film detector, 3 scattered photons strike the detector, that is 75% of the photons striking the detector carry little or no useful information concerning the patient anatomy. For larger patients, the SPR in the abdomen can be up to 6. Thus, it is required to minimize the magnitude of a scattered radiation reaching the image receptor. The variation of image contrast with amount of scattered radiation expressed in terms of contrast reduction factor, that is S, here is shown in the figure. Now we will see what are the methods of scattered radiation. The magnitude of scattered radiation needs to be minimized for improving the image quality, that is contrast. A mechanical device called anti-scatter grid is commonly used in the majority of radiographic projections. The grid is placed between the patient and the image receptor, e.g. a screen film cassette, to reduce the amount of scatter reaching the detector, as shown in the figure. The grids are designed to allow a large proportion of the primary photons to reach the image receptor while removing a good proportion of the scattered photons from the radiation field. Selective absorption of scattered radiation by an anti-scatter grid is shown in the figure. The image quality can further be improved by careful collimation and by patient compression. Collimation is an easy way to reduce the amount of scattered radiation by collimating the X-ray field to include only the anatomy of interest. Alternatives to anti-scatter grids include the use of air gaps and slit scanning systems. So now we will start with anti-scatter grid. The anti-scatter grid is used to minimize the effects of a scatter radiation in projection radiography. The use of a grid is the most effective and practical method of removing a portion of a scattered radiation. It consists of an array of strips of an X-ray absorbing material, usually lead, and a relatively non-absorbing interspace material, usually fiber, carbon or aluminium. The grid strips are aligned with the direction of the primary X-ray beam, as has been shown in the figure. The lead strips are separated by an interspace material and have protective covers, low atomic number material usually used for the cover, on the top and the bottom. In most grids, the interspaces are angled so as to align with a specific point in a space and called as focus grid. The focal point of the grid should coincide with the focal point of the X-ray tube, which is the source of the primary radiation. Typical grid focal lengths are 100 cm for general radiography and 183 cm for chest radiography. Unfocused or parallel grid, the interspaces and strips are parallel and are not aligned with a single point in a space. Because the X-ray beam direction is aligned with the grid, much of the primary radiation passes through the interspaces without encountering the lead strips. The scattered radiation leaves the patient's body in a direction different from that of the primary beam, and hence a large portion of it is absorbed by the grid, because a scattered radiation is not generally lined up with the grid strips. Unfocused grids always have some degree of grid cutoff and should not be used at short distances. The construction and design parameters of anti-scatter grid is illustrated in the figures shown here. The number of lead strip lines per centimeter is called a strip frequency, and the ratio of the height h of the lead strips to the width of the interspace d is known as the grid ratio r, which is given by grid ratio r is equal to a strip height h upon interspace width d. The working ability of a grid is described by the grid ratio, and it ranges from 5:1 to 16:1. Grids of ratios 8:1 for 70 to 90 kV, 10:1 and 12:1 for more than 90 kV are commonly used in radiography, and grid of ratio 5:1 is typically used in mammography. The grid is essentially a 1D collimator, and increasing the grid ratio increases the degree of collimation. Higher grid ratio provides better scatter elimination and hence better image contrast, but at a cost of increased patient dose. The table presents construction details of typical grids used in radiography. So we can summarize the grid parameters as a strip frequency, that is nothing but number of lead strips per centimeter, grid ratio, that is h upon d, working ability of grid is described by r, grid of ratios 8:1 and others are used for different KVP, grid is essentially a 1D collimator, higher grid ratio provides better scatter elimination, and these parameters of typical grids are summarized in the given table. Now in this table you can see that grid ratio r for the grids of 10:1 and 12:1 is given that parameters are a strip frequency, which is in the unit of centimeter is inverse, a strip height h in millimeter, interspace width d in millimeter, and a strip width t is also in millimeter. So typically for a 10:1 grid, The strip frequency is 33 or even it can be 40. The strip height is 2.5 or 2. Interspace width is 0.25 and 2. And the strip width is 0.05 in both the cases. And in case of 12:1 grid, the strip frequency is 57 per centimeter. 1.56 is a strip height. 0.13 is the interspace width and 0.045 is the strip thickness. When the grid is stationary, X-ray shadow of grid lines appear in the radiographic images, which is generally unacceptable. To eliminate this, the grid can be moved in the direction perpendicular to the direction of the slits. A mechanism usually provided to oscillate the grid in a direction perpendicular to the grid lines, which blurs the grid bars so that they are not visible on the image. The device that moves the grid on a radiographic system is called bucky. The information related to total penetration of radiation, both primary and scattered, through the grid is necessary to select appropriate exposure parameters. Total grid penetration is a function of primary and scattered radiation penetration. The figure shows the relation between grid ratio and penetration of primary and scattered radiation. It can be seen that penetration of both primary and scattered radiation decreases with increasing grid ratio. The grid penetration is generally expressed in terms of bucky factor, named after Dr. Gustav Bucky, who constructed the first grid in 1913, which is defined as reciprocal of the total grid penetration, that is, bucky factor is equal to 1 upon grid penetration PG, which is equal to exposure with grid in MAS upon exposure without grid in MAS. So, the figure shows relation between bucky factor with KB of the X-ray machine. Now, we must have a special remark on grid cutoff. Focused grids must be used at the correct focal distance within a permissible tolerance. If this grid is used at the wrong distance, the tilt of the lead strips will not match the angle of divergence of the primary beam. The primary beam will then be attenuated progressively more towards the edge of the image, and hence there will be cutoff of the radiation. The bucky factor describes one aspect of the performance of a grid under a set of clinical conditions, including KB and patient thickness. The relation between bucky factor, KBP and grid ratio are shown in the figure. The bucky factor ranges from 3 to 5. The contrast improvement factor, CIF, is the ratio of the contrast when a specific grid is used compared with the contrast without the grid. That is, the contrast improvement factor is equal to contrast with grid upon contrast without grid, which is in symbolic form given as capital TP upon capital TT, where TP is the primary radiation penetration or transmission through the grid and TT is the total radiation penetration or transmission in the absence of the grid. The relation between contrast and grid ratio is given in the figure. CIF is a function of the grid penetration characteristic and the amount of scattered radiation. The relation between the contrast improvement and grid ratio strongly depends on the proportion of scattered radiation in the beam emerging from the patient body, and hence, it is a function of patient thickness, field size, and kilovoltage. We will summarize this module with following important points. Enough scattered X-ray photons are produced in almost all the radiographic procedures except mammography. Projection radiography is a planar imaging technique where image of a three-dimensional object is recorded in two dimension. Contrast is the ratio of the signal difference to the average signal. Image contrast depends on the subject contrast and the characteristic of the image receptor. High image contrast is desirable to visualize disease features of the patient in medical imaging. The magnitude of a scattered radiation is expressed in terms of a scatter fraction SF and a scatter to primary ratio SPR. A scattered radiation causes a loss of contrast in the image, which is quantified by contrast reduction factor CRF or contrast degradation factor CDF or a scatter factor S. Anti-scatter grid is used to reduce the magnitude of scattered radiation and improve the image quality. Use of air gap and slit scanning system is alternatives to anti-scatter grid for scatter reduction. The focused, unfocused and moving grids are used in medical imaging for improvement in image contrast. Grid ratio is an important parameter of the grid. Performance of a grid is evaluated in terms of Wacke factor and contrast improvement factor. So, with this, we conclude module 8. Thank you.